Morning, it's Simon here, and hopefully today is going to be another splendid day. The sun is out, which is always a wonderful start, but I have like a few things on my mind, so let's get started. Okay, I'm going to walk in this direction because there's people that way and feeling a bit self-conscious. So what do I want to talk about today? I'm walking past my house, which is this one here, and I'm pretty sure my sister's like looking at me through the window right now, laughing at me, thinking I'm strange for videoing myself. But hey ho, so let's get started. What do I want to talk about today? I want to talk about making the day awesome. You see, I was out yesterday with my family and my uncle reminded me of a really important philosophy to me which I'd sort of neglected to live by, which is living for every day. Now, I know it's a cliche, but let me explain my theory. A lot of you guys, I'm not gonna lie, I'm sorry, but a lot of you guys spend whole your entire life, you know, you're working, right? So you go to school, why? So that you work now to enjoy the future. But when you're at school, the future is university, where you work hard now to enjoy the future. But then the future after university is a job, where you work hard now to enjoy the future. And this future is just retiring. And then you're 90 years old, and you've been working hard your whole life, and you think to yourself like, I'm gonna change directions. And you know, you think you reach like 65 when you finally retired and you're in the future, the time you're supposed to enjoy. And you're like, you know, you've got all the money that you've saved up and it's your time to enjoy it, but you've got like 10, 15 years to enjoy it maximum. That's if you don't die early. And so that's a pretty gloomy story. That's the reality of life for a lot of the way people live it. Let me tell you a little bit about my philosophy. Okay, let's say I'm gonna live for 90 years. I might not live for 90 years, I might live for 70 years. I might live for 5 more years. I might die on New Year's Eve. I don't know when I'm gonna die, honestly. But I'm a bit scared that I'm gonna die on New Year's Eve because I think there might be an ISIS attack. Just like a theory, not a theory, but just a fear. But anyway, that's not really the point what I'm trying to say. What I'm trying to say is, my theory of life is I don't know when I'm gonna die, but let's say I'm gonna die at 90 years old. I don't wanna work my whole life to enjoy the year 70 to 90, no. Because when I'm age 70, I'm gonna look back on my life and think, gosh, you know what, I just wish I enjoyed the whole process. Because when I look back on my childhood, all I think is, gosh, I wish I spent more time enjoying it. I know that in 10 years from now, when I look back at my university life, I'm going to think to myself, gosh, I wish I just spent more time enjoying it. I'm starting today's video again. I already sort of started recording one and then I ended up just not saying the words I wanted to say. So, good morning again. I want to tell you something about life. A lot of people have this philosophy, work hard today and enjoy tomorrow. Which, in theory, is nice. But the thing is, work hard today and enjoy tomorrow is not a theory. It's a mindset, right? If your mindset is, I'm going to work hard today to enjoy tomorrow, then tomorrow, you're going to keep that mindset, saying, I'm going to work hard today to enjoy tomorrow. And then the next day, you're going to work hard today to enjoy tomorrow. And you're going to go your whole life, you know, school, education, high school, university, job, retire. And you're gonna go for your whole life, work hard today, work hard today, work hard today, bang, 65, retire, enjoy tomorrow. No thank you. Because I tell you what, when I'm 65, I'm gonna look back on my life and all I'm gonna think is, gosh, I wish I actually just enjoyed the whole thing and didn't spend so much time worrying and spend more time just enjoying life. So, it's weird living by this philosophy. And it's hard to live by this philosophy, especially when there's so much pressure. Especially when there's so much pressure just to enjoy. I just fell over. When there's so much pressure to work hard today. I'm not saying don't work hard today. I'm saying don't worry today, because I'm literally telling you, when you're 90 years old, you're going to be worrying about something different. You're always going to be worrying about something. So just save your time, because you're going to be worrying about something no matter where you are, no matter what you're doing. You're always going to be worrying. And if that thing is done, then in 2 weeks from now, you're going to be worrying about something else. Because worrying, I'm going to tell you something about worrying. We don't worry about the thing we're worrying about. Worrying is a state of mind. And this, even if you eradicate everything from your life that you could worry about, you're still going to find something to worry about because your mind is used to worrying. That's why we keep worrying as humans, because it's just a state of mind. So you need to just, first of all, become aware of the fact that you're worrying and just stop freaking worrying, because, and just get it into your head and like look at your past and realize that you're just going to worry about something. So just save your time, because when you're done worrying about that, you're going to be worrying about something different. There's this car that keeps looking at me and the wind keeps blowing in my face. There he goes. Anyway, so let's get back to the point. So what point am I trying to say? I'm trying to make two points today. Number one, don't worry. Like, just don't worry, because worrying is just a waste of time. And when you'll reach a certain age when you realize that when you look back on your life, all you're gonna wish is that you worried less at that time and enjoyed it more. Well, today is that time that you should be enjoying it more and stop worrying. Because in 20 years from now, you're gonna look back on today and say, gosh, I wish I just enjoyed that day and didn't worry about it, because in the bigger picture, it wasn't even that big a deal. Which brings me on to the second thing I wanna say. Yes, there are two things I wanna say this video, two things. Number one, do not worry, because just enjoy the day, man. Don't worry about it. Just enjoy it. Second thing I wanna say is about a bit of a philosophy of mine about life. So it was a philosophy I was saying earlier when I fell over, you know, when I stood by that fence, remember that, before I went on that tangent about worrying? Kind of related. A lot of people go through their lives, man, work hard today and enjoy tomorrow. But I was out with my cousins and I realized life is, I don't want to work hard my whole life to reach retirement age and enjoy my retirement. I don't want to do that, because because when I reach 65, the only thing I'm going to wish is that I enjoyed my youth. I enjoyed my life and my funness while I had it. And I wish I didn't work so hard, and I wish I didn't worry so much about work. That's the way I'm going to think. And so, if that's how I'm going to think when I'm 65, oh, I wish when I was a teenager I just enjoyed it more and didn't worry so much about stupid teenager stuff, then I'm going to enjoy my life and not worry so much about stupid teenager stuff. Like, I'm just not going to worry about it. I'll be dead soon, man. I'm just going to enjoy it. And, like, you don't even know when you're going to die. Like, I could die really soon. Just could. So, just enjoy every day. Every day, enjoy it. There's always going to be something to worry about. There's always going to be something to worry about, so don't worry. Like, because there's always going to be something. So just save your time worrying about it and just enjoy every day, man. Do you see what I'm trying to say? Wait, I'm trying to get the sun out of my face. Can't really do it. I'm going to just do this. Save your time worrying and just enjoy every day. Like, have I expressed this properly? I think I have. And this leads me to the final thing I want to say. I said there was two things I want to say, but third thing, how do we actually do it? It's a nice philosophy, but practically, how do we do it? So, let's get stuck in. First one, worrying. Let's start with the first one. How do we stop worrying and just enjoy it? For me, I believe that looking back on the last few days of your life, like the last month of your life, and just have a think about the stuff you've worried about, or like the last year of your life, and I don't know, just have a think about the stuff you've worried about, and then you'll realize like how much stuff you've worried about in the last year, and how silly it was, because it happened anyway. Your worrying didn't save your time. Maybe you don't know where you're going to be living next year, and you spent loads of time worrying about it, but then you got a place in the end. And so, how to stop worrying? Look at the times which you've worried, and ask yourself, was it worthwhile wasting my time worrying? Because it happened anyway. Did worrying help? No. Okay, if you can do this, now you're probably at a point where you think, okay, Simon has actually got a point here. There's no point worrying, because whatever's going to happen is going to happen anyway. And if we can change it, we can change it instead of worrying about it. So there's no point worrying. Instead, just enjoy it. Don't worry about it. But that leads to the next point of, okay, but sometimes I worry and I can't stop worrying. I know I shouldn't worry, but I worry. This leads me to my next point, which I'm going to talk about in my garden. So my garden's quite shady. I'll show you my garden. It's quite a shady garden. Oh, I miss the summer, man. Right, come on. I was on a serious put. Look, this is why you wear wellies, because when the ground is condensationy, it really helps. Okay, so what was I saying? Okay, quick recap. This video, we're making 2 points. Save your time worrying, and number 2, enjoy every day. Point number 3 was saying, okay, how do we do this? Starting with number 1, worrying. Technique. First part of the technique, realizing the past stuff you've worried about and asking yourself, was it worth worrying about it? And then you'll realize no, because it happened anyway or you did something about it. So worrying was a waste of time. And you now have a perspective that worrying is a waste of time. The second part of how to stop worrying is this. Every time you're worrying, be aware of the fact that you're worrying. And just remember, just know that it's a waste of freaking time worrying. Just enjoy it, because you're going to be dead soon. And this is your life. And when you're 90 years old, you're going to look back on today and wish that you didn't ruin today by worrying about tomorrow. And you just enjoyed today. So it's an awareness. It's the second part of worrying. Okay, so worrying, number 1, like we said, A, is look back on your life. Look at the times that you've worried and look at how much of a waste of time it was. Hopefully get a bit more perspective. 1B is 1B is an awareness. So sometimes we worry and we're not aware of it. So try and become aware of times when you are worrying. And when you're aware that you are worrying, just tell yourself, I am worrying. And worrying is so silly. I'm just going to enjoy today. Sometimes it's hard to stop worrying because we worry without an awareness of it. Okay, second point that we covered in this video was enjoying every day. How on earth do we enjoy every day in our lives? We know that we shouldn't worry because life is short, and instead of worrying, we should just enjoy it. We learned that in part 1B. Oh, I don't know if what I just said just recorded, because I pressed pause. Anyway, so. Okay, so this is the way the video works. We have part 1, which is worrying. Part 2, which is enjoying every day. Part 3, how to stop worrying. How to actually do it. And then we said number 1, A, was looking back at times you've worried and realizing how silly it was. 1B is having an awareness of worrying. And now we're on to part 2, which is enjoying every day. That's where we are. So, part 2, enjoying every day. How do we enjoy every day in our lives? Like, I woke up this morning, I'm not gonna lie, I didn't feel that good. I was playing Habbo and I was talking to this random lady from America. She's about my age, studying chemistry, and I was just thinking to myself, this is really nice, but am I really sad? See, sometimes you just wake up and the day is just set up to be a bad day. I went down into my lounge and the curtains were shut and I was just like not with it really. I was with it, but I wasn't doing anything. How do we enjoy every day? And so this one, I truly believe we're just gonna, like, there's so many things to be happy in life. Sometimes people say, oh, there's a recipe to happiness. If there is a recipe, it's the most complex recipe. For me, being happy is having an attitude of gratitude. Being happy is having close connections with people. Being happy is having high self-esteem and not being insecure in yourself. Being happy is being free from fear or having a good mechanism to coping in fear. Being happy is doing something you love every day and actually doing stuff that makes you happy and putting it into action. Being happy is having faith and stepping out in that faith. There's so much to being happy, and there's no one thing which is going to make you happy, but there's just a recipe of making you happy. I believe the heart of that recipe is 2 things. Here we go. 2. A, how to enjoy every day and be happy is do something you love, man. Do something you love. Now, how do we know what we love? You see, Sometimes we think we know what we love and we do it and we're not actually that happy, and then we think we're depressed because the thing that used to make us happy doesn't make us that happy anymore. Well, guess what? People grow, people change, and the stuff that used to make you happy might not make you happy as it used to. So what is doing what you love? This is a long video, I'm sorry. Doing what you love is doing what you really feel like doing. And like just something like, for example, just like something you really want to do, something fun. Like this morning I woke up and I thought to myself, gosh, I want to make today awesome. It's not going to be awesome unless I do something I love to do. So I thought to myself, what do I love to do? Well, jumping out of an aeroplane. That would be awesome. If I could do that today would be a good day. I'm not going to jump out of an aeroplane today. I'm sorry, I'm not going to jump out of an aeroplane today. Does that mean today is going to be a bad day? No! Because of the other part of this, which I'm not going to talk about just yet. But even though I cannot jump out of an aeroplane today, I can book it for tomorrow or for next week. And then once it's booked, I'm going to be doing something awesome. You see, having a happy life means putting your perspective into action. If you have a wish to do something, we are not given a wish that we cannot achieve. The only thing is, maybe we need to book it, maybe we need to pay for it, maybe we need to plan it, but we can achieve it. If we have it on our hearts, if we have a wish, we can do whatever we want. So today, I woke up saying I want to jump out of an aeroplane. So I'm going to jump out of an aeroplane. Not today, but I'm going to book it today. I'm going to plan it today. I'm going to research it today. I'm going to bring myself one step closer. And you just realize you can do it. The second part of enjoying every day for me is community and spending time with people that make you laugh and make you happy. You see, there is nothing in life that brings happiness like fun with other people. I'm going to step out into the sun so you can see me better, even though I can't see the camera better, because I care about you. Even though I'm the only one that watches these videos. There's nothing that brings more happiness in life than fun times with other people. Like, I could jump out of a plane alone and have loads of fun. Or I could jump out of a plane or jump out of a plane at half the height with a friend and have three times the amount of fun. Because the best experiences are the shared experiences with real caring people and loving people. So having someone in your day that makes you laugh and doesn't make you feel alone and someone you connected with, and do something with them, man. Like if you go around their house, if you do whatever, that community time, it's worthwhile. It's really worthwhile, man. So obviously there is a larger recipe to life, such as overcoming fear, such as blah-de-blah-de-blah, blah-de-blah-de-blah-de-blah-de-blah. But these are just two simple steps to enjoy every day and to stop worrying. Don't get me wrong, if you want to be happy in your life, you can be miserable and be a not worrier, and you can be miserable, kind of miserable, and enjoy every day. So there is a larger recipe, but these are just two little stepping stones, which I wanted to share. So I feel like we've covered not a lot in a long amount of time, which shows how bad I am at explaining stuff. So we're going to do a quick recap next to this tree, which represents the mistletoe with a lack of a partner in my life. Recap. What have we covered today? We've covered two issues: worrying too much and not enjoying your life. Then we came up with solutions, which was our third step. The solution for worrying is two parts. Part A is looking back on your life and thought about times where you've worried in the past month or the past year, and what you've worried about, and then realized how you wish you behaved in that time. And in that time, I bet you wish that you did not spend your time worrying and just enjoyed it, because it wasn't as bad as you was worrying it would be. The second part, 1B, to stop worrying, is being aware of the fact that you're worrying and then just enjoying yourself instead. You can't stop worrying unless you're aware of the fact that you're worrying. Sometimes we just live in it like this. And sometimes you need to just be aware. It's like, wait, I'm worrying right now, but I know that worrying in the past has just been a waste of time, so I'm going to save that time today. I'm just going to enjoy myself. And then the second topic we covered was enjoying every day. How do we enjoy every day in our lives? Do something you love every day. If it's a bungee jump that you want to do, you plan your bungee jump. Maybe you can't bungee jump today, but you can plan it for tomorrow. And then you'll enjoy tomorrow, and you'll probably be happy today because you're going to be going bungee jumping tomorrow. And then the second way to enjoy every day starting today It's spending time with people, man. Like, people that make you laugh, people that you don't need to pretend with, people that you care about. And these people, they make you feel good. Spending time with people that make you feel good makes you feel good. It's weird, isn't it? Not really. I hope you've enjoyed these little steps and pieces of advice. I really hope you enjoy your day and you don't worry about anything today. Peace off. I totally stole that peace off thing. I like saying peace out. I don't know why I said peace off. Peace out. So, what am I going to do today? I love how I have to keep pushing my hair in my face. Well, today I'm going to practice exactly what I preached. I'm going to plan jumping out of an aeroplane. Just going to plan it. And then I'm going to... Oh, sorry, before I do that... Oh, look at that. Ow. Before I'm going to do that, I'm going to spend time with people I love. I'm going to spend time with my family. I'm actually going to do what I love to do, which was part 2A, with people I love, which was part 2B. How awesome is that? What a good day this is going to be. And then in the evening, I think I'm just going to relax. You see, to really enjoy the day, you need to take charge of it and dictate what you're going to do in your day. But if you dictate it too much, then you're a bit of a control freak and you have no flexibility. So decide what you're going to do, who you're going to do it with, which is what second part of what we spoke about. And just dictate your day a little bit. That's what I'm doing. Peace out. Like I said earlier on, I'm going to come outside again. Like I said earlier on, there is so much more to this recipe of happiness than just these two things. For example, expressing yourself is another really important thing. Like for me, it makes me feel so much more stable in my life emotionally. So do just be aware this is not like gonna make you have the most fantastic lives like this, but it's a stepping stone, and that's what it's all about, just tiny little stepping stones. And then, you know, I mean, what was that? I hope you've enjoyed this video. I've been a lot less gloomy, haven't I? Look at this. Been a lot less gloomy. Peace. It's because I've been able to put into practice my perspectives, whereas on Christmas Day and Boxing Day, I couldn't because the day was already dictated for me. Wow, look at that long sentence. So I'm going to play football, like I said, with James and Tom and my uncle later. Hopefully it's going to be good. I'm feeling like it's going to be a really good day. But there's a part of me which is feeling like it might not be a good day because I don't know what I'm doing with the evening, because I haven't dictated what I'm doing in the evening yet. Look how pretty this is. Look how quickly I'm talking. So there's a bit of me which is like, oh, okay, I'm going to enjoy it with my cousins, but then I might not enjoy the evening because I haven't dictated what I'm going to do in the evening yet. But you don't need to dictate it too much. You know, like, I don't need to dictate every single microsecond of my life. I can just dictate it a little bit. Then go with the flow. Sometimes it's really good to go with the flow, but if you go with the flow too much, then you're just lazy. I'm not in fast forward. I'm just talking like this. And you know, this is a learning journey. It's a stepping stone, like I said. So, you know, the first stepping stone I said was about expressing myself, and I'm expressing myself every day now, and it's feeling really good just by doing this every day. And it was just a stepping stone. And all these stepping stones I'm saying right now is just like, phew, stepping stones to a happier life, you know. So maybe I will need to micromanage every day, but I really don't think I need to. Why am I talking so quick? I don't know. Okay, I'm going to slow it down and just express how I'm feeling now. I'm feeling that today is going to be a good day. But I do not know if today will be good all day, because I don't know what I'm doing in the evening. Yeah, that was really strange. I'm just gonna leave that at that. I think you heard what I said. I said it really fast and really slow. So if you can understand really fast or really slow things, then good for you. If not, then I'm really sorry. I can't help you. I don't do an in between. That's just what I do. So yeah, I don't know how to eat. This evening's gonna go. I'm just gonna go with the flow. I've dictated my day a little bit, but I'm also gonna go with the flow a little bit. So I'm just gonna see. Hopefully it'll be good. There's a part of me which just wishes that like I could have my life figured out already. But I'm 19 years old and I'm pretty like ahead of the game, like with all this stuff, you know what I mean? And anyway, this is such a long video and the day hasn't even started, and I'm gonna talk more later in the evening anyway. So maybe I should stop, but I love it. I love it so much. It's so good just like getting all this like boom out there, like bang. And like when I'm in a good mood, I even enjoy it more. But when I'm in a sad mood, I enjoy it. I just enjoy this, man. It's like just like fully just expressing myself, man. I was playing the piano earlier. I made such a nice song. I called it A Waltz in the Summer. I called it A Waltz in the Summer because it wasn't a waltz. Maybe it was like, What could I call this song? Let me think. I called the song Room Full of Light because as I was playing it, the light was coming in these doors and I was on the grand piano. I feel really spoilt. And the song was just all about light just entering a room and like you have the little pieces of dust just like filtering through the light that you can see coming through the window. It's just a beautiful song. I really want to start doing dance lessons and piano lessons as well. I've got a list of that on my phone. See, that's another thing. Like, when I say do something you love every day, sometimes you wake up in the morning and you're just completely uninspired. You just think to yourself, gosh, like, I want to enjoy today, I want to do something I love today, but I just can't think of anything I love to do today. That's why, like, I choose some like, extreme stuff, like jumping out of a plane, because I can't think of anything small to do, so I have to think out of the box. But then throughout my day, I have, like, a list of things on my phone, like, dance lessons, piano lessons. Like, if I have any good ideas of stuff that I would love to do, I just put it on this list. And then if I want to love the day, I can just, but I don't know what to do, I can just look through this list and like, oh, that was an idea that I'd love to do. I'm going to do that today. Bum, 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 do 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 I've got my eye on you. Bum, 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 bum. You know the words?
Well, it's like a glamour chili hot intuitus.
She treats me like a slave.
Get glamour chili hot intuitus.
Okay, Hannah, I'll get them for you. Captain Simon on the way. I'm going to get the best brother award today. I'm going to get her Doritos from her bedroom. I truly am the best brother in the whole world. Okay, where are they? They're in her white cupboard or something. Okay, I'm going to stop talking like a weirdo. She said they're in her white cupboard. Found them. Do 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 do. Here you go, Hannah. What do you say?
Thank you.
No, what do you say? Do 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 do. Say great job. Great job. I'm just on my way to go meet them now and play football. And like, it just puts me in so much of a better mood knowing that I can make my day fun if I want to make it fun. And like, it doesn't have to be gloomy all the time. Like, the past few days have been gloomy days. Like, maybe not yesterday. Yesterday was a good day. But just like the last few days, I've been like talking and expressing myself on the camera. Like, I've had a lot of negative emotion to express. And I'm thinking to myself, like, when I'm back at uni, maybe I'm going to have more good days because there's more to do. I don't know. But, sorry, I always get self-conscious when the cars go past. I'm going to think to myself, maybe, like, I'm going to have more good days. Maybe I'm going to have more bad days. I don't know. But these whole YouTube videos, it's just going to be a journey. And, yeah, I've not started the best. But you know what? Like, it's a journey. And, it's okay. It's okay! It's okay, don't worry. Like I said, I have a really good feeling about this channel as well, because sometimes I get really happy and I don't know how to express it. So I end up expressing it with people, and when I express it with people, I'm a bit overbearing. Like, it's okay to express it with people, don't get me wrong, but like, I can be extremely overbearing because I get extremely happy. So I love the way I can just express it on here. And also sometimes I get extremely sad. I'm not like bipolar, I don't think. I'm going to a counsellor because I get afraid of being insane and not normal. And I don't like that fear, so I'm gonna get very too in my head and self-aware and overthinking. Like I said, connections and feeling not normal. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, so what I was gonna say is I love that I have this channel just to express everything that I am, and I'm very expressive as a person. I'm overly expressive. I love it, man. I love feeling the emotion. Great things are gonna happen with this channel. Great job. Great job. Great job. This is probably gonna be a long video because I keep making videos today. On the subject of having a happy life and stuff, sometimes when we go through sad times and life gets busy, we lose ourselves. Have you ever heard that expression? You lose yourself. You stop doing the stuff that makes you happy. And I was just talking to my uncle, and he said that he went through a time in his life when he wanted to rediscover himself. And he used to love to paint, so he started painting again. And my video, I didn't actually upload it, but it was about Spider-Man. And as I got older, I lost myself, and I rediscovered myself by watching Spider-Man again. It's always a way to rediscover yourself. And it's nostalgic, and it's personal, and it's intimate, and it's awesome, it's beautiful. Rediscovering yourself, getting back in touch with something that you used to love. Remember what I said earlier about just chilling? I'm just chilling with James right now.
Don't be weird.
Right now I'm just chilling with James and Tom and Uncle Manix and James. I'm not doing anything. I'm literally not. I'm just chilling out with them. It's the best. Chilling out with people, man. So awesome. Which was part 2B of what I said this morning. Well, with Tom and Manny Fu.
Yellow.
And so much fun. So much fun. And it's so freaking, I don't know how well you can see this. You can't see it. This doesn't do it justice, man. It's like a sunset. I'm gonna have to switch camera. Oh, so good. So good, isn't it, bro?
So good.
How was my football today, Tom?
Very good, very good.
I played against some 3-year-olds.
Actually, there were 9.
The 9-year-olds. And it was really easy. I don't know if it's because I'm a good footballer or because it's just an age thing. What do you think, Tom?
Good.
You reckon?
Watch this ultimate number.
Good job. I've been saying good job oh wait, can you see it now? Oh, look at that. Look at that. We've been playing. It's been so freaking nice. Love my new shoes. And Uncle Manny thinks I have the potential, doesn't he? Yeah.
Maybe a bit too old though.
A bit too old?
Yeah.
I've got the speed.
Yeah.
I've got the potential.
Maybe.
I'm not the best, I'm not gonna lie. But I feel like I've got the fitness. And I feel like I've got the basics. I just need a bit more confidence taking people on. And a bit more confidence, a bit more confidence really on the ball, that's all. But it'll come with practice.
Yes, it will.
Did I ask you to talk?
No.
Sorry about
that. I broke my collarbone.
Huh?
I broke my collarbone.
You broke your collarbone?
Yeah.
Good. Sorry about him. I love my bro.
No, I didn't nutmeg you.
He's trying to nutmeg mead.
I almost did it. Oh! Lay it back!
Lay it back, Tom. Good job.
He turned to me as if to say, hurry boy, it's waiting there for you. Gotta take
I just wanted to make another, like, I just was in my bedroom and I just really wanted to make another video before I went to bed. So I really wanted to talk about today because today was so awesome. Oh man, I'm telling you, I just scared a cat. Today was so freaking awesome, man. But I'm gonna walk down a bit because I don't want to wake any houses up. As you could probably tell, I just made it awesome because everything I said this morning happened. Do you remember what I said about enjoying every day? It's a simple recipe. How do I enjoy every day? Number one, dictate your day and put something you love in your day. Number two, spend time with people that make you feel good. Like, did you know people are like drugs? They actually make us feel good by being around them. You need alone time too, but people actually make you feel good. Even when you're doing nothing. You can be at home and do nothing and be miserable, or you can be around people and be happy, if you're with the right people. So, let me just express to you today. Oh, wait, I just woke a house up. Keep running, I just woke up someone. Okay, we're clear. Let me express to you today. Is this better? You can see my face here. It was just so awesome, and like, I just gotta express this. So, this morning, I just chilled for a bit, played some piano, cooked a delicious breakfast. I love cooking, man. Such a fun outlet. I cooked a delicious breakfast, chilled in the morning. Then I went to the Foo's house during the day. I got there about 2 o'clock. That's how long I was chilling this morning. But it was fine. I went for a little vlog this morning, cooked some food. It was fine. I just took advantage of that car's headlights to illuminate me. Did you notice that? You're welcome. Oh, the stars are so pretty. Anyway, then I went out, and I tell you what, it was such a highlight just going out with James and Tom. James didn't come, it was just going out with Tom and Manny. I've bonded with Tom so much this holiday. Like, I've bonded with him so much. I love that little boy so much. Like, let me go get some light. You don't even know how much I love him, man. I love that boy, like, more than I love myself. Bonded with him, bro. Like, we just had so much fun. What did we do? We went and got a KFC together. Like, when I was at the Foo's as well, we were just like chilling for ages, as you saw with that brief video with James in. Like, just being around the people that make you feel good makes you feel good. And it takes away loneliness, which we're going to talk about soon. This is going to be a long video. Okay, so where do we begin? So I was just chilling around theirs, and then we went out and, like, what did we even freaking do? We went and got a KFC, and then we went to Whitecliff and started playing football. And we didn't spend that much time in KFC. We didn't spend that much time in Whitecliff. And thinking about time, we arrived in Poole after we had KFC and after we played Whitecliff. We got to Poole around 4:30, like 4:40, and we only left the house at 3:00, which means it's like like an hour and a half. But it was amazing. It felt like longer. It must have been longer. We were just playing football for like not even that long. And it's a real love of mine. Like, I'll tell you what, Uncle Manix said this thing earlier. I videoed it about rediscovering yourself. Rediscovering the things you used to love. Now, sometimes the things you used to love don't make you happy anymore, but sometimes they do. You just rediscover it, man. And really rediscovering myself with football, definitely, and PlayStation. Love it. And Spider-Man. As the video which I will post will show you, I get really deep and emotional, and I'm just like stood there saying nothing, like this, and then I'm like, I am Spider-Man. But it was like a big identity moment for me. What else? There's someone there, and like, I'm just feeling very self-conscious right now. Oh well. What else? So that was awesome. I'm pretty sure she wanted to walk down this road, but she chose against it because it was just some weird man stood there like this. Anyway, went to Whitecliff playing football, rediscovering myself. That passion! Freaking loved it! It was so fun! Just playing with Tom and just like, I'm at a time in my life right now where I don't care too much what other people think, even though I just got self-conscious. I didn't really get that self-conscious. I more just said it for the video. But not really. But anyway, I'm kind of at a point in my life right now where I really don't care what people think. So when I was playing football, I would just like not care what people think. Like, I was celebrating not caring what people think, and it made it even more fun than it used to be. love it. I love the fact that you bond with people while you play football. What else? So, oh yeah, and after that we went to pool. Me and we picked out a nice shirt for James with Uncle Manix, and he just really was making an effort to pick things out for other people, which just reminded me about caring for others as well. It's something which we really forget. And just, yeah, the way he bought something for someone else, man, it was really nice. He bought something for James, and he was looking out for Auntie Say. He really loves Auntie Say. I like when I talk, you can kind of see this muscle. Wait, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Hello? La 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 la, you see? Just keep your eye on that for a second. Oh, you see? Anyway, I laugh when I'm not finding stuff funny, but I do find it funny. Welcome to my life! What did we do then? We went to pool, like I said. We picked out a new top for James, which is freaking awesome, just because, like, spending some time with Uncle Manix and Tom was so freaking cool, man! And then, we got some tap water from Starbucks, and just, like, the whole time, me and Tom were just playing together. Like, I had so much fun with him. I love him so much. That's my neighbour, old neighbour Sean Morris. We used to be really good friends, then just stopped talking to me. Sorry, I just really needed a minute. Oh no, it's coming back. She just stopped talking to me, man. I don't know if I'm weird or just real. I think I'm just very real. Very in touch with my emotions. Okay, that wasn't actually a real cry. So we had a lot of fun in pool. We didn't even do that much, just being with them was fun. Uncle Manny said this really funny thing where he wanted to buy a sausage roll because he thought it was a good deal. But then the deal wasn't as good as he thought it was, but he bought a sausage roll anyway because he didn't want to muck the lady around. Oh, I love him. Then we told him we were full and he bought the sausage roll. I thought he bought it for himself. And it was like, oh, here you go, Simon. And I was like, until I told you I'm not hungry. But then he was like, gave it to Tom, and Tom was like, until I told you I'm not hungry. And then he's like, just eat it. And then we realised, like, why he bought it. He bought it just to be polite, because he wasn't hungry either. And so, there's a car pulled up. Oh, well, I'm going home tomorrow. Well, to Brighton. Is it home? I don't know, because I've loved being home so much this Christmas. Because the foods were actually here. Anyway, what was the other thing? There was another thing. So, oh yeah, and then it just came back to the foods, and again, just spending time, like, around people that I love and make me feel good. Like, spending time with people that make you feel good. There's nothing that beats it. And something which really touched me today was Tom. Like, I know I keep going on about Tom, but he really got sad because he was going to miss me. And the stars are so beautiful. And that just really touched me, the way, like, he cared so much about me. Like, it really meant a lot to me. I caught all the cars unlocking. Oh, no! Ah! Oh well, it's in the past. I read a really interesting quote today on another topic, which says, you can choose your past and your future. You see, you can choose what future you want to have, and you can choose what past you have by deciding what to do in the present, because as soon as you've done it, it becomes your past. I love that. You choose your own story. I wish all these ideas would just sink into my mind. Perspective, use it or lose it. I've got to start using this stuff more. And so now I'm back home, and I really just craved some alone time, I think. Just because even though I love being around people, I am an introvert at times. And, like, I love doing things like this, like getting in touch with my emotions. And I can't always do that when I'm around people. So I even actually got this feeling when I was at the Foos. I was like, nah, I need some Simon time. I need some alone time. So now I'm going to talk about a subject which I want to talk about. I don't know whether to put it in today's video or a different video, because I think this is making a very long video. I'm going to make it for tomorrow's video. So, I love you so much. Peace out. Thanks for watching. Thanks for coming to my channel. I hope you come back again. I know it's long videos, I know all that, but I love it. I love it. If you don't like my channel, then just keep coming back, because I'm sure I can win you over. I tend to do that with people. I like people liking me, which means I suck at saying no. And, like, I can't stop talking to you, because that's how much I love your face. So I'll see you in tomorrow's vid. Mwah.